I'm pretty sick of spending my whole entire wage at Woolworths every single week, so we are now going to go out and we are going to go spear a fish and do a full cook-up tutorial. Oh god, yeah. So here we are, arrived at Nudgee Beach. We're going to get all set up here and ready for spear fishing. I'm gonna walk my board and place it right here. And I'll put this box on top. Here are my flippers. Boop, boop. And my knife and my goggles and my Adrenoprocidon. Great, we're all nicely set up here. So all I need to do is lock the car. I usually put my key just in this location. I've got cash in my car, my wallet, my credit cards. If you know what my car looks like, come take it all. Alrighty, so what I'm hoping is that from some of these boats over here, all their sewage tanks are getting emptied into this nice river. Oh my god. And what we're gonna go do is we're gonna go out to one of these points out here and hopefully there'll be fish eating some of the human feces and I can spear a nice fish. Ooh. Well, I made it to the sign. This is useless. The water's so murky. I'm so scared of jumping in the water, I'll get eaten by a shark. Look, a plane. Anyway, I'm gonna head. I'm gonna head over there to those mangroves. Oh, so warm. Looking really sunburnt. Ah. Onwards. Whoa! Oh, they're just birds. Oh yeah. Here we are in the mangroves. This is actually really nice. It's really, really nice in here. There's lots of little fish. I'm gonna find a mud crab and I'm gonna catch a fish. So I just found this line here and I'm way too eager to see what's on the other end. Just a heads up, if you're gonna lift up someone's pot, be prepared to get run over by their boat. This really pisses people off. Anyhow, I'm not taking the crabs, so it's alright. These ones look like females because they got quite small claws, but I haven't checked the undersides of them, so I wouldn't have a single clue. I'll chuck this back anyhow. Onwards. I just found this little spot here, so I'm gonna jump in and have a look if there's any fish around. I mean, the water's looking pretty murky. I got nothing. I also jumped in the shit water. Hey, look, a syringe. I also jumped in the syringe water. Look, a pacifier. A dummy. I've never called it a pacifier in my life. Until now. I jumped in the pacifier and syringe water. And now I'm probably gonna get sick and I don't have any food. I finally decided after this little dive that the water was just not gonna clear up and there was not a chance of me finding a fish. I decided to head straight home, unpack absolutely everything. It was actually really nice out there. I mean, I got extremely severely sunburnt and my forehead is now peeling off. All in all though, I got some nice exercise and now it's time to cook. Well guys, we're back home now. And all in all, I think that was a very unsuccessful day. And as promised, we're now gonna cook. So, let's get right into it. What you wanna do is you wanna start off by heating up a nice pot of water. We're going to be putting a lid on this one so that the water boils rapidly. We wanna set our oven to 200 degrees and we'll put the double burner on. We're gonna get ourselves a nice deep tray. And what you wanna do is you wanna place your knot fish in the center. Grab a nice sprinkling of olive oil, put that on top just like that. A good heaping helping of salt, way more pepper than salt, a bigger pepper to salt ratio. Perfect. Now you want to grab a little bit of oregano. You don't want to grab too much because this actually is quite strong tasting. Just like that. Next we're going to be grabbing our what I think might be thyme, or maybe it's more oregano, I don't actually know. We're going to spread that out nicely over top of the fish, just as so. We'll grab a little bit and we'll also put it inside of the fish. Next, we're going to grab our fennel bulb. Cut that in half. We're going to wrap the fish around the fennel so that all the flavor of the fennel goes into the fish. Second one just here. Boom. Lovely. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to grab a lovely tomato, slice that into 6 slices. It doesn't really matter how many slices you slice it into, it's just how many slices I wanted to slice the tomato into. We're going to spread this around the fish so that juices seep into the fish and the fish juices seep into the tomato. We're going to grab our chilies. We're going to slice one of them in half. This one is going to act as the main spice component in the fish. The other two are kind of just there for decoration. Just like that. Grab a nice sprig of basil and another nice sprig of basil and a nice sprig of rosemary. Perfect. We're going to set this aside, check our water, it's ready to put the potatoes in. We're going to slice the potatoes up. Boom. All sliced. Now this is a very crucial part. What you're going to do is just after salting it, we're going to throw the potato in so that it burns you. Perfect. Yes. Perfect. Once we got that step out of the way, we're going to chuck the rest of the potatoes in, put a lid on top and let them boil, right? We're going to set a timer to 20 minutes. Potatoes are done. Time to put them in the fish dish. You want to just spread them out evenly. It doesn't really matter where you place the potatoes, as long as they can get air to them so that they're not covered by the fish or any of the vegetables. That just makes it so they can crispy up nicely. Just as so. Now we're gonna wanna get some butter. Betty had a bit of butter, but the butter was too bitter, so Betty got some other butter to make the bitter butter better. Putting butter over top of some of the potatoes will actually crispy them up a little bit better as well. Oops. A little bit more salt, even though we definitely don't need any more salt. And some more pepper. Alrighty, it's time to chuck this one in the oven. We'll probably leave it in there for about 20 minutes, just like the potatoes boiled for. Right, we've got one crucial step here. Make sure you get a big steam burn. Yes, perfect. Alrighty, make sure the towel flops into it. Yep, nice, adds some flavor. Great, so what we're gonna do here is we're gonna check the fish and see if it's ready. Mm. That looks ready to me, so we're gonna put this onto our chopping board. There we are. Great, looks good. Chuck a little bit on the plate. Lovely. Now we're just gonna place our potatoes. We're gonna go for a nice minimalist aesthetic with not too many vegetables and not too much fish. This part is optional, but if you want to, you can grab some of the fennel. The fish itself has actually absorbed a lot of the flavor of the fennel already, but what I like to do is just chuck a little bit on top. Grab the end bits because they're the crispiest. Slice nice and fine. And put that as so. Lovely. We'll grab one of these chilies just for looks. Brilliant. A little bit more pepper. And of course, gonna put way more salt on it because obviously it needs way more salt. A nice drizzle of olive oil. And I think we're done there. Delicious. Well, there you have it, guys. That was my no catch and cook. I'm gonna go eat this now because I'm really hungry. Really, really hungry. Stay tuned for more videos.